Hey boy, it's hot outside, it's summertime down here in the south, and it's time for a barbecue. So what I've got down here is some beef ribs. These are choice from Winn-Dixie, USDA choice natural beef aged for tenderness. And what I got over here, this is going to be a paid commercial from Burnt to Perfection rub. He's got three different sizes, and Burnt to Perfection all meat seasoning, it says. For best results, always rub your meat before grilling. How about that? His website is www.burnttoperfection.com. We're going to try his rubs. He used to be known as Dick's Rub. Dick's Rub. He changed the name. I wonder why. All right, so first thing we're going to do, these things been cut with a meat saw up at the butcher. We're going to rinse them off to get any bone fragments off the outside of them. I got my... You need to tighten up a little bit, don't you? Keep falling down by yourself. So, to get the bone fragments off the edges and plus whatever the butcher may have had on his hands off too. And got the smoke up getting fired up, and we're going to go put them out there shortly. You ain't fogging up all you. Don't look like it. It's pretty humid out here. Alright, so I got the smoker ready with some hickory down in there and some Kingsford in the charcoal pan. And there is the chimney sitting on top of the propane pit and got lit. The coals ain't quite ready yet. I don't think I showed y'all this before. But this pit was built in 1976. It's got three air holes down here. So there's no adjustments on this thing. All you do is set you a load of coal in it, start assembling it, and I'm not using water in the water pan. I've got some ceramic briquettes, kind of like lava rocks, except they're more dense. They're heavier, and I got them covered with foil so they don't get all full of grease. I can just throw the foil away afterwards. But we got to get the coals in there first. I also made a modification. I cut a little door in the side of it where I can add more wood as I go. Alright? They're all ready. Down here, boy. Gonna pour them right there on there. In there like that. Well, that's a lot of coals there, GB. Oh well. I'm gonna start building here. First thing, we're going to put the water pan with no water right on top of that. We're going to put a cooking grate right on top of that. And we're going to get a slab of these ribs. Come off of that. Not both of y'all, just one. Come here. Look at that, just like that. Make room for the cutoff piece. I told that dumb butcher to quit doing that. All right, I'm going to put another section on here. Just like that. Get our next slab of ribs. Put the cut off. Now it's got another section down over here, but we don't need it. All we need to put the top on it. No adjustments. Smoke, boy. Go. This company's out of business. It's made by Kelly Manufacturing Company. It's called a Big Boy water charcoal smoke or something like that. I still got the manual that come with it, believe it or not. I hope you was recording. That sound you hear is my fan running. It's hot out here. We going back in the air conditioning and drink some pops. I know what y'all gonna start asking me. What temperature you cook your ribs at? How long you cook your ribs for? That smoker, you don't, there ain't no adjustments on it. So it cooks where it wants to. Depends on how hard the wind's blowing, what the temperature is outside. Today it's about 95 in the shade. So I guess it's gonna probably cook it around 275, wherever in the hell it wants to. That's without the water pan. You put the water pan in there, and that's a heat sink. In other words, it keeps the temperature lower in the smoker, so it takes longer to smoke stuff. Hint, hint, tip, tip. Don't add no moisture. Well, once the meat starts cooking, it the muscles draw up, and the moisture, if anything, it's gonna come out. It ain't gonna go back in. Trust me, boy. It's physics. It's quantum physics. Damn, people. All right. How long till they look done? Probably about 3-4 hours. They beef ribs, so they're already tender. All you got to do is render some of the fat out of them. It's the ribeye steak is attached to that part of the rib, and that's what they cut off when they trim them. That's what a prime rib is. It's that with the meat attached, the ribeye attached. All right, so I made one of these the other week, and I didn't record a video, or I think maybe I did. Anyway, beef summer sausage. I'm gonna remove that casing that's around the outside of it, and I'm gonna take an apple core and core out the center and stuff garlic down in there. And I'm gonna rub the outside of it with some Zatarain's Creole mustard. We're gonna put that on the smoker. But it don't need too long, because you can eat this just like this. It's ready to eat. All we're gonna do is kind of warm it through and give it a little extra smoke on the outside and on that Creole mustard. And the last time I made it, I put a dry rub on it. It didn't need that. The rub is salty. This is already seasoned pretty damn good. It don't need nothing else. It ain't like breakfast sausage that could maybe use a little bit of salt, say if you was making a fatty, which Google it if you don't know what a fatty is. Once again, I want to thank Mr. Dick Lang for sending me his Burnt to Perfection all meat seasoning. And paying me to make this commercial for him. And we're gonna try it out. I've already tasted it, and it tastes real good. I like it. It's different than Slap Your Mama. This is a barbecue dry rub. Slap Your Mama is it's different. It's not necessarily a barbecue dry rub. It's got too much salt in it for that. It's better for just general season all, Cajun season all, whereas this is specifically not necessarily. He says, put it on anything. You put it on eggs if you want. You put it on your hand and lick it off just like I just did. You know what it'd be good on? It's popcorn. It's got a good flavor. It'd be excellent on popcorn. Fresh popcorn rather than salt, use his stuff. Yum.